If you've ever been to New York City, you've probably swallowed a copepod. These tiny planktonic crustaceans can be found in New York City tap water. And it's purposeful. The invertebrates help eliminate mosquito larvae from the water supply, though I suppose that technically means it's not vegan.
Whale sharks are the largest living filter-feeding fish. While it's possible to observe their eating behaviors, they most frequently eat at night, and sometimes at depths too difficult to study effectively. One way scientists have started tracing the whale shark's diet is by looking at the nitrogen composition of copepods that live on whale shark lips.
Noise in the ocean has been shown to impact the lives of plenty of marine animals. Whales and dolphins may respond to noise by beaching themselves. Fish may disperse when disturbed by unknown sounds. Even copepods seem to have a negative response to sound. In lab settings, copepods exposed to simulated cargo ship sounds became stressed and ate less.
Copepods are also not fans of flashing lights. These small crustaceans eat plankton, such as dinoflagellates, that float through the water column. To fend off a copepod attack, some dinoflagellates flash bright, self-made light, which annoys the copepods and scares them away.
It's not just copepod prey that can glow, however. Copepods are also able to produce bioluminescent light. In the Arctic, copepods may be washed up on shore during strong tides. No strangers to freezing temperatures, they glow blue in slushy snowdrifts.
Did you know that humans are the final hosts to a type of nematode that can only get into us if we consume the intermediate copepod hosts? The nematode causes guinea worm disease in people, and they become infected by drinking water or eating raw fish containing host copepods. They're a different species from the New York City copepods.
Not all copepods are minuscule. While the smallest species are not much larger than a single grain of sand, the largest species can reach more than a foot in length. These long fellows are external parasites to dolphins and whales.
If you've ever watched the show SpongeBob SquarePants, or been exposed to it in some way, you've probably seen the most famous copepod character of the modern day. Sheldon J. Plankton, who is often referred to simply as Plankton in the show, is a copepod.
In the SpongeBob show, Plankton is constantly trying to steal a Krabby Patty. However, real-life copepods eat a variety of foods. Some eat single-celled algae, called diatoms, and they can eat hundreds of thousands of these algae in a single day.
Although copepods are planktonic and unable to swim against water currents, these small crustaceans are able to swim. In fact, some can swim so fast, if they were human-sized, they could swim 50 miles in just an hour.
You've also probably heard that copepods live almost everywhere, and not all species have eyes. But if you weren't aware of these facts, you can learn all about them and more in our full copepod episode. There's a card on screen you can click right now. Go ahead, click it. There's lots to learn. And thanks for watching Animal Fact Files.